Today, no cooking. In this video, I would like to explain how to find the perfect flour for your recipe and be able to buy flour knowing what are the characteristics of it. At the end of this video, I will share a very important table that will help you to have more knowledge about flour. Let's start from the grain, which contains three parts. The endosperm is 83% of the grain, is the source of white flour. The bran, which is the outer skin, contains protein and vitamin, and the germ, which contains healthy fats. The issue in understanding flour is that each country has different classification. Here I'm trying to mention the most common flours: cake flour, all-purpose flour, bread flour, and all wheat. The difference between this flour is made from the amount of bran. More bran for the whole wheat and less for the cake flour. And so on. Now we see the difference between flours with the higher and lower amount of bran. We consider four aspects: lightness, development, flavor, and smell. For a flour with a low amount of bran, we will have more lightness and development, less flavor and fragrance. In a flour rich in bran, you will find the opposite characteristic. When we buy flour, one of the most important values that you need to know is not mentioned in the bag. This value is called W. W is the strength of the flour. It's expressed in number and it goes from 80 to 350. Lower is the W and lower will be the strength of the flour. How to find the perfect flour for your recipe? Every recipe needs its own flour. So here is a table with group of preparation with the right amount of strength expressed in W. 80 to 160 W will be fine for cookies and cakes. 180 to 240 for focaccia, bread and pizza. 240 to 320 for croissant, high hydration or long fermentation dough. 300 to 320 or more for brioche bread, panettone or dough with a lot of butter. Now the most important part. How can I know the W of a flour if it's not reported anywhere? In every flour it's mandatory to indicate the percentage of protein. From that you can convert the W following this table. So, for example, if you have a bread flour with 10% of protein, it means that you will have a not very strong flour, with only 160 W. Instead, if you have a bread flour with 13% of protein, you will have a strong flour with 300 W. Choosing the right flour is very important to achieve the right result. I hope this video will help you to understand better how to use flour, and thanks for watching.